life coach and professional speaker, Maria Milagros here. Happy Wisdom Wednesday. Thank you so much for choosing to spend some of your time with me today. During this month of August, we have been talking about change, the power of change, the necessity of change, and the reality that life is change. We're constantly changing and evolving as people, as we grow from being a baby to being elderly. Our lives are changing, our jobs change, where we live changes, you know, our clothes change. Whole life is change. Our entire life is about change. And so this week in particular, I want us to focus on this change, because the reality is that nothing changes unless something changes. And a lot of times with my coaching clients, not a lot, all the time with my coaching clients, they're looking for a change in their life rather than recognizing that they themselves are the catalyst for change. They have everything that they need for change. So that's my job, is to help them see that, tap into that, and then embrace it, and then fully participate in it. Because when you're fully participating in the change that's happening, you get to steer some of that change. You get to decide what changes and what doesn't, you know, for some of the things, not for everything, because you're not the only person on the planet. But you do get to participate in it. And then when you have a positive perspective and a positive attitude and you change the way you perceive it, it's fun, it's easy, it's light, it's love, it's loose, it's, you know, all of those things. If you are looking for the one person who's going to come along and change your life, go look in the mirror, because that is honestly the one person who is fully capable of changing your life on a sustainable level. I have met people that I've had conversations with, or I've heard them talk, or I've read their books, and it created a change in me, absolutely. But I cannot say that one person changed my life. No. Because if I'm not in the right mindset or in the right place to receive that information, then I'm just getting information. You know that there have been times that you've said something to someone like 1,000 times, and then they hear it from someone else somewhere different, and they go, did you know? Like, it was a light bulb for them. It's because they weren't in a space to receive it before, and they were in a space to receive it at that moment from this new person. Now, did that person that they hear it from change their life? Not really. They did provide information that created some change, or probably that inspires some change, but the change has to happen within, right? And change has to be, in order for it to be sustainable, it has to be done one small step at a time, because the reality is that the only thing that creates drastic change in our life is trauma. And so we don't want to run around traumatizing each other or ourselves in order to get instant change. It takes time. So we have to be kind to ourselves, acknowledging that it is a process and that we don't have to stay where we were, and getting to where we want to be will take time to get there. And along the way, we get to enjoy what is happening. We get to enjoy the changes and the evolution that is occurring along the way. And when you do that, you're not just accepting change, you're embracing it. And again, you're fully participating in change. So two quick stories. One, there was a guy that I know, and I hadn't seen him in a while, and I ran into him. And the first thing he started telling me was how horrible his ex-girlfriend was, and this horrible thing that she had done to him, and horrible, and how horrible of a human she was. And so I kind of let him go for a little while, and then I realized he kept circling back to the beginning of the story as if he didn't already tell me. So I stopped him and I said, let me ask you a question. How many times have you told this story? And he's like, oh, well, you know, people should know. Stop. How many times have you told this story? I want you to really, like, think about it. Give me a number. How many people have you told this story to, or to yourself? How many times? The number was ridiculous. And I said, so are you done telling this story? Because one, she's not the worst person in the world. She's really not. No person is. People are generally making decisions that they believe have a payoff so that they can feel temporarily powerful, happy, peace, something. No one repeats a behavior that doesn't have a payoff. So this is her pattern. You attracted her for a reason. You two ended up colliding at the very end. But is she the worst person in the world? No, not really. And if we take a second, this is what I said to him, if we take a second and think about some of the stuff that you've done, she is not the worst person in the world. Neither are you. I'm just saying you can't say she's horrible when you've done similar things, right? So we have to stop telling that story, and we have to change the story that we're telling. So instead, I just started saying to him, you know, maybe she comes from a background where her parents, this was what she saw what her parents do. He said, oh yeah, definitely. So she's just repeating behaviors that she saw from before, which means that she's just running off of old programming, which means that she doesn't know really any better, because if she did, most people who know better do better. So we have to trust that. And she doesn't think that she's fully deserving, so she sabotages her relationships. And so that kind of makes me sad for her. And so then in this point, maybe we shouldn't be condemning her. Maybe we should just be sending her love. Maybe we should just be sending her vibrations of light. And good thing that you figured out that you're in a healthier space and that she doesn't match up with your space right now. That's a good thing. And he was like, oh, yeah. So then as we began to change the way that we told the story, he said, oh my gosh, I feel so light. I feel like I lost all this weight. Okay, good. Stop telling that story, because that story is not beneficial for you. And you're getting all worked up and into a tent, like a little tizzy every time you tell the story. And you can't move into a space of light and love if you're not operating from a space of light and love. So I hope that example makes sense. The other one was, I ran into a coworker, an old coworker, just the other day, and she looked like she was glowing. Right? And so I said to her, oh my gosh, you look so easy. You look so light. You look so like that, like an exhale. And she said, you know what? I just got tired of telling myself that sad story, and I got tired of my excuses, and I just made changes in my life, and I started doing more things that I enjoy doing, and I started dressing the way that I want to dress, and I started taking care of my body, and I feel so good. That's what she kept saying, and I feel so good. And I just, yes, girl, because you recognize that no matter what was happening around you, the only person responsible for your happiness, which you are deserving of, is you. The only person who really knows how to make you feel good is you. And you found healthy ways to do that. That's my goal for all of my clients, is to help them find healthy ways that they can get to a space where they're feeling good, they're carrying around this sense of joy and peace and, you know, happiness and light and love, because we deserve it. And the truth of the matter is we can't go from 0 to 60 instantaneously, especially if we've been running off of these old programs, especially if we, again, don't really know any better, especially if we haven't fully acknowledged that we're the catalyst for our life's change. So sometimes it's good to change your environment, or to change your outfit, or to change your hairstyle, but where you are, there you are. So if you don't change what's happening in here first, it doesn't matter what you do out here or out what happens out here, because the only real sustainable change happens from within. And then if you want to shave your hair off, do it. If you want to change your style of dress, do it. Like, who cares? None of that really matters. What matters is what's happening in here. Acknowledging and recognizing that you're amazing, that you're capable, that you're deserving. That's the key, is that you are deserving of a good life. You're deserving of happiness, and you're never going to find that in expensive things or in brand new furniture or in a big fancy house. Or it'll make you happy for a few minutes, maybe even days, maybe weeks if you're lucky, but it's not sustainable, because that's not where real happiness comes from. The change that needs to happen has to happen here first. And it comes, that for me, and when I teach my clients, it comes from changing the way that we think about ourselves, changing the words that we use, you know, capturing our thoughts, practicing thought, you know, an attitude of gratitude, and practicing affirmations regularly, remembering who we are and whose we are, and that we are royalty and deserving and worthy of all the good that life has to offer. And I'm not talking about stuff, even though there's nothing wrong with stuff. I'm talking about the good, you know, the light, the love, the easy, the fun, the carefree, that. So that's what I have for you today. I hope that this was beneficial. I hope that you take a real hard look at yourself in the mirror, actually a real soft look at yourself in the mirror, and just extend love to yourself and tap into everything that you need to do for yourself to get yourself to a place where you live the life that you deserve, because that is super sparkly everything. Okay, so I love you so much. I hope you have a great rest of your week and a fantastic, super sparkly